course, very honored to be on the Legends cover. That's a huge honor for me.
Yeah, I can't really even describe it. You know how it feels when I seen the cover. I was just blown away.
To be on the cover.
Check out the fashion style of the Bucks as they enter the building. Bring out the red carpet. That's a great look at our location tonight, the home of the Suns here in downtown Phoenix. The NBA on 2K Sports. It's a beautiful Sunday afternoon. This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Greg Anthony and Brent Beard. David Aldridge will join us momentarily from the sideline. DA, take it away.
Well, Kevin, even though starters are important, those great sixth men have been the key to so many championship teams. Think about the likes of Andre Iguodala, Manu Ginobili, Lamar Odom. And still, with some, there's a stigma to coming off the bench. Iguodala said it's ingrained early, but in particular, he said, in the NBA, it's I need to get paid like a starter. And guys, that's a sacrifice that not many are willing to line up for.
David Aldridge, thank you. Lots of speed and athleticism on the floor tonight, Brent. What do you think could determine the outcome?
Well, if guys are going to play fast, Kevin, and guys are going to be up in the air, it's going to come down to very solid decision-making to see who it is that separates themselves in this one.
Here are the starters for Milwaukee. Middleton and Giannis are the forward tandem. Dante DiVincenzo, who's out there with Holiday, and it's Lopez in at the center. And for the Suns, Booker and Bridges are the wings. Jay Crowder out there with Ayton, and it's Paul in at the one. Now here is Holiday. Tipped away. Here is Ayton. And Ayton throws it down.
Chris Paul came into the league playing unselfish, continues to do so. What a dime.
And Holiday gets to Middleton. Now the pass to DiVincenzo. Outside Holiday. Pass to Antetokounmpo. Just tried to shoot. Goes up. It's good. The assist that time from Holiday.
Not sure how he saw that there. Holiday with a firm understanding how to get the ball to an open teammate.
And you go back, Giannis Antetokounmpo, the 15th pick in that 2013 draft. Hindsight, obviously 2020, but I think it's safe to say he should have been drafted a little bit higher.
Yeah, you have so many of those blogs out there to go back and want to redraft classes. Giannis Antetokounmpo back in 2013, I'm pretty sure at this point would be taken number one.
Here's Holiday. Devin Booker picking up that last basket. Pass to Middleton. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. Mikal Bridges picks one up.
There's so much about this 3 and D in terms of the wings in the NBA. Chris Middleton really embodies all of that. He can do some damage behind the arc and then is asked to guard the team's most potent offensive wing. A great player on a great role at the charity stripe. He has got to be careful about being too aggressive on him and sending him back for freebies.
Well, he is looking confident. Love how they're using him so far.
Yeah, right now I don't see any let up. I think he's going to just keep putting his foot on that gas pedal tonight.
Now here is Holiday. Pass to DiVincenzo. Outside, Antetokounmpo. Outside, Holiday. Off target with his three. The Suns have got their first three shots to go in for to start off this game. And the rejection by Antetokounmpo.
This is when length becomes a massive, massive positive. What a shot block by Giannis.
On the wing, Holiday. Defended by Bridges. Holiday, the pass to Antetokounmpo. And Antetokounmpo slams it in.
Man, he sure can get off the floor.
He's one of the best in the business, absolutely. Booker against DiVincenzo. Wall looking over the floor. Here's Bridges. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
If Bridges attacks with that kind of force, it's really hard to knock out.
It's his first trip to the line.
And going back to his performance at the line last year, guys, 84% as a free throw shooter.
The Bucks have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Giannis gives to Holland. To the paint. DiVincenzo gets the bucket.
Uncovered at the rim, finding cracks in the defense here early on.
Just really smart basketball and exploiting whatever holes that he's seeing right now in the defensive squad.
Now here's Paul. Booker draws the double. The pass to Crowder. Good. Nice assist from Booker.
Booker is a special offensive player. Can score and starting to show his playmaking.
Holiday dishes to Antetokounmpo. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. It's going to be on Jay Crowder. Milwaukee shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
And talking about last season, this team hit just 74% of their free throws. I'm sure they were hoping better than that.
Here's what Phoenix has got going on right now. Sharich checked in free. Johnson comes in for Jay Crowder. Torrey Craig. He's checked in for Bridges, and Cameron Payne subbed in for Paulson. And slam dunk by Sharic.
The defense not putting up much of a fight as Sharic gets to the rim.
Bucks trail by three. Holiday, the pass to Portis. Back to Holiday. And it's slammed in by Holiday.
And credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, well, I can say a little for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that.
Here's Booker, following the bucket by the bucket. Johnson can't hit.
Well, the D's so tight on him, it makes him alter his shot. And an easy chance turns into a tough one because the defense is swarming.
It's stolen by Johnson. 1:24 left in the first quarter. Now here's Payne, still looking for his first bucket in this one.
Oh, what a pass, and then he lays it in. The circus.
So smooth. Floats it up for Giannis. He'll hit that one.
And what should have been a simple pass and finish ends up in a missed opportunity on that alley-oop attempt.
Yeah, you like to keep things a little more simple, and that was a play that didn't quite develop the way they wanted it.
Excellent on both ends of that play.
Yeah, the steal was sharp, but the slam topped it off.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. Have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
Yeah, that's a high percentage look when the D doesn't fight over the screen.
And the coach over there just asking for one simple thing, and that's some effort got burned on that one.
Here's Connaughton. Here's Giannis. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
And Phoenix making a change here. Ayton's checked in. P.J. Tucker, he's checked in for Milwaukee.
Well, a little bit each year, Giannis gets fouled at a higher and higher clip. That shows about how much more aggressive and how much more confident and how much more usage he's had through his first few seasons.
Holiday, the pass to Antetokounmpo. Yes, and it's Holiday with the assist that time. Antetokounmpo's got 11 points.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
Pass to Ayton. 1 second left. And it is good! The buzzer!
End the quarter there. Team is pumped up.
All right, his first quarter of play. We've seen plenty of offense so far. Suns lead by one. And don't go away. We'll be back with the action for the start of the second quarter in just a moment. And earlier, we checked in with Giannis Antetokounmpo, who had this to say about losing to the Raptors back in 2019. All part of the process of achieving greatness.
Yeah, and most guys have had to go through it. MJ, LeBron, leading a team to a championship rarely happens early on.
And close game underway so far. We'll see if either of these teams can jump out in the second quarter. What stands out to you from the Suns in this one?
Well, the coaches preach ball movement, and we saw exactly why in that first quarter.
Everybody just feeling the energy of the basketball as they moved it around. Lots of hands were touching it.
Johnson and Jaric are the three and the four.
Payne out there with Devin.
Oh, man. That's some flashy stuff from Antetokounmpo. They're dicing up the D with the ball control.
It's Payne with the ball. He'll bring it up for Phoenix. Sharich outside. Kicks to Booker. Score the basket. His fourth. He's only missed one of his five shots tonight.
One of the more skilled offensive players that is on the floor here tonight. Not an easy fella to hold in check.
And Antetokounmpo slams it in.
Yeah, you could throw that pass just about anywhere, even the top of the square for Giannis to go and get.
Hey, looking around. On the wing, Booker. Hey, Greg, if you could coach one team right now, who would it be?
That's a tough one. Clippers, Lakers, Bucks. You know what? I would probably go Lakers or Bucks because you would have an opportunity to coach someone who arguably might be considered the best to ever play the game. I think Giannis is trending in that direction, and LeBron obviously already is.
How about a guy like Kemba Walker and coaching the Celtics, having him to do what you want to do on the floor?
He'd be brilliant, and Kemba was one of the most underrated leaders in our game. Great, great human being.
Some changes for Phoenix. Jake Crowder's checked in for Sharich. Bridges comes in for Johnson. And Paul subbed in for Cameron Payne. The Bucks also changing it up. Brook Lopez is checked in for Giannis Antetokounmpo. Chris Middleton comes in for Pat Connaughton. And it's Dante DiVincenzo in for Jrue Holiday. Paul outside. Here's Booker. Lopez with the block.
That's out of there. Not a high riser, but Lopez using his frame, a smart block, if you will.
Ayton against DiVincenzo. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Oh, no one around him. Good. Nice assist from Booker. Booker's got three assists in the game. Bucks trail by three.
And Devin Booker had surgery on that right hand back in the summer of 2018. Took the opportunity to work on his left hand, and ever since, his game has just gone to another level.
I wonder how much confidence, GA, he's had in making plays, not only scoring the ball with the left hand, but assisting with the left hand, and what that's opened up for him in terms of opportunities to be more effective as an offensive weapon.
A tremendous Mobile One block that we had to see again. Great send back.
Close games can boil down to who makes plays on defense, and that is one heck of a rejection right there.
Quarter two, and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. Fades. Forbes with the rebound.
He wanted to keep that shot from getting blocked, but in the process, he gave it no chance of going in because of how unbalanced he was on the fade.
And first time out of the game called for Phoenix.
So whether things are good, bad, or indifferent, coaches will have adjustments to make throughout the course of the game.
Yeah, not just there to pump up or to discipline players. You got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team in the right mindset to carry it out.
Phoenix has gone 3-3 from three-point land here tonight. Ball outside, and here's Booker from the arc. That's the sixth make from the field. He's taken 9 shots and missed but 3.
Catching and shooting with confidence. Devin Booker letting it fly.
Here is Forbes. drop falls in. Forge has got four this quarter.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
Inside, Ayton, and Lopez pulls it down.
Oh, you can tell right there he just wanted to go for the jam, but the defense too good and distracting.
Here's Forbes. Doesn't go that time. Now the Suns take it the other way. Hooker, right side. And another one in the scoring column for him. He's 7-10 from the field.
He's got a lot to do with the position that they're in. A very smart offensive performance tonight for him.
Timeout called. The Bucks. Kind of like what Devin Booker is doing in this one.
Gotta be using this timeout to think about a personnel change or a game plan change to try to slow him down.
Some changes here for the Bucks. Portis, he's checked in for PJ Tucker. And it's Holiday in for Bryn Forbes. Portis finds Holiday. Whole team on Holiday. And Portis throws it down.
There is no coach that does not ask his point guard to distribute the ball. Holiday did just that for that time.
1:53 left to play here in the second quarter. Here's Booker. And he drops it in from the low post. Booker's got the lead up to four now for the Suns. And here's Holiday, who will bring it up for the Milwaukee Bucks. DiVincenzo against Booker. Basket good.
Such a smart offensive play right there. When Holiday sees that chance open up right there, he's all over.
Booker against DiVincenzo. Let's it go from 14. DiVincenzo with the rebound. For Milwaukee, they've gone 7-10 here in the second quarter. They'd like to keep up that nice pace. The shot by Holiday, no good.
That's the only way to take him out of his comfort zone from that range. Get right up in the jersey, force him off the spot. For him, it's harder to miss that shot than it is to make that shot. I think he was anticipating a bit of a bump there.
Good D by Booker.
I think he rushed that one just a little bit, thinking the defense was going to get close. They weren't.
Bridges shot. Good.
Consistent shooter like Bridges loves to get openings from the mid-range like that to get his rhythm.
And Middleton kicks to Portis. And Holiday throws it down.
Love seeing a point guard who can explode to the rim like that.
Oh, great attitude and even a better finish.
Well, just seeking out weaknesses in the defense and then exploiting it.
And it's Ayton missing. Bucks have gone 8-13 in the second quarter, well above the 50% mark from the field. Holiday looking over the floor. Passes it to Portis. And there's the foul on Jay Crowder. That's foul number two for him. Here's Connaughton. She's over Green. And that's it for the first half of action. What's been a very close game here. The Suns on top, up by two. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin, here with Coach.
All right, David, thank you, and stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to the NBA on 2K. Devin Booker putting in some incredible work. He had 18 points, 3 assists, and 1 rebound. He's been a different player than he was their last outing when he was off his game. He's rounded back into form tonight. Kenny, let's start with you. What did you think about the Suns?
Well, they were consistent from downtown. The playmakers found open shooters in the street.
Thanks for joining us, folks.
It's been fairly even so far. You know, guys, Devin Booker has been exceptional here.
Really impressed with the shot selection through the first half. Just taking what he can get from the defense.
And I'm thinking back to the first half and wondering, did he take a low percentage shot? Everything efficient.
The Suns leading. And on the floor for Mike Budenholzer, starting the second half. Giannis is the four with Lopez the five. Dante DiVincenzo, he's out there with Holiday, and it's Middleton hitting the small forward. Buck shooting has been just fantastic, around 65% tonight, getting exactly what they want, when they want. Here's Lopez. The Bucks getting another chance here. The score now all even. Lopez has got the first points to start out the third quarter for the Bucks. To the middle, here's Ayton. Good. Nice assist from Booker.
Ayton pouring a foundation there on the inside, just living in the paint.
Crowder against Giannis. Now here's DiVincenzo. Defense right on him. Lopez finds Holiday. Six on the shot clock. Puts it up. A three for DiVincenzo. Rebound by the Suns. What you love about front, he gives you a little bit of everything at both ends.
I mean, defensively, he'll take on anybody. He's smart, draws a lot of charges. Offensively, he can stretch the floor, and he'll make the extra pass. He's also an opportunistic rebounder.
Bucks trail by four. On the wing, Holiday, defended by Paul, and the basket is good.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Suns have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Phoenix calls timeout. Looking at current NBA players, Greg, leaving aside the real star players, who would you love to have played with from this year?
There's so many guys that, and I hate to call them role players because they bring so much more to the table. But in reality, they got to fill some roles, right? And, you know, John Collins is a guy who's got great potential, a tremendous finisher around the rim. How about Robert Covington, a smooth shooter who defends his tail off? Davis Bertans, a deadly floor spacer who can put the ball down and create and make plays. So there's so many guys like that in the league that make a difference in determining whether your team can win or lose.
Boy, those are three names I don't know that I would have mentioned, so I'm glad you did. Count it. Good. Middleton's got the game tied up here for the Bucks.
That's impressive. Flying towards the hoop, Chris Middleton saw just enough of a takeoff area to get to the rim.
Near the three-point line, it's Booker. And again, it's the Suns missing.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss or two.
Yeah, that happens. Important thing is for players, just don't beat yourself up and make a miss like that cost you another play.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. All against Holiday. Now here's Paul. D right on him. Drilled from 11 feet out. Paul's got 5 points so far.
Nothing better than a hustle play like that. It gets the whole team amped up. Sets the example for everyone.
And Chris Paul picks up the foul. That's his first foul. So for the Suns, Sharks checked in for DeAndre. Johnson comes in for Bridges. And it's Payne in for Chris Paul. P.J. Tucker, he's checked in for Milwaukee. Bryn Forbes comes in for Drew Holiday. To the inside. Here's Giannis. You can't get that one. The Suns go the other way with it. Johnson with it. Now guarded by Middleton. Johnson can't hit. And here's Middleton bringing it up now for the Milwaukee Bucks. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. And they double up Antetokounmpo. Middleton looking it over. And here is DiVincenzo. 5 points in the game. Here's Giannis. And Antetokounmpo slams it in.
That reach is just ridiculous. Giannis easily beating everybody to the ball and then sends it back.
Dane passes to Šarić. Up to Payne. Here's Crowder. The rebound by the Bucks.
Well, a lot of players in the league are going to make that shot, and for him, it's pretty much automatic. It's a good defensive effort to prevent the layup. Well, looking into the gaps of the defense there, he's not going to miss many of those when he gets to that range.
Here's Booker. DiVincenzo with the rebound.
More good work on the glass there. When it's all said and done, I think rebounding might tell the story in this game. And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Booker the pass to Johnson. Outside Crowder. This one for three. Antetokounmpo pulls it in. Giannis has got 8 rebounds in this game. In the corner, Middleton with it. Buries the long-range jumper. Middleton's got the lead up to 9 now for the Bucks.
And the advantage they have starting to increase. Things are coming together for them at a really opportune time.
Coaches always talk about the first 5 minutes of the third quarter. They have definitely increased their energy level here.
Here's Crowder. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2. And there's the foul against Milwaukee. The Suns shooting their 5th and 6 free throws of the game. And the first one at the line is good. Andre Ayton's checked in for Sharks. Portis is checked in for the Bucks. Dan Connaughton comes in for Brent Forbes. 46 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. DiVincenzo against Booker. And there's the call on DeAndre Ayton. That is his first foul of the game. Mikal Bridges checked in for Phoenix. Drew Holiday is checked in for Milwaukee. Here's Connaughton. No points in the game hit for him. For 3, Middleton. Phoenix grabs the miss. Ayton's got 5 rebounds tonight. 4 seconds separate in the shot. Game blocks and contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. That one is on Holiday.
Well, Bridges doing a good job fighting hard past the foul, even after the release.
All free throws good from Bridges.
And even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line. Yeah, take your time. You don't give them another possession.
Yeah, hopefully that's what they'll do here. It's what most teams try to execute at this time in the game.
Outside Holiday. In time, and the last shot at the buzzer doesn't go in for him. Well, it's been an exciting game. Plenty of offense as we head to the fourth quarter. Bucks ahead as they wrap up the third quarter on a 15-6 run. And when we return, we'll get the fourth quarter rolling right here on 2K Sports. I can't wait to see what kind of finish awaits us here in the fourth quarter. Bucks leading by 5. Booker and Bridges are the wings. Andre Ayton out there with Johnson. And it's Paul in at the point guard position. That's who's out there for Phoenix.
Sprinting up the floor and beating everyone down. That's the reward for Chris Middleton.
Ball passes to Booker. He kicks to Bridges. And he makes good on the way.
That's pretty steady from Bridges. Does not let the contact throw him off one bit.
The Bucks shooting a superb 63% from the field. Now a timeout called by Milwaukee.
And Bones, Devin Booker, capable of big nights. One of just a few players with multiple games of at least 59 points.
Well, he's always looking to put pressure on the defense. And he's got such a wide array of skills. Not only shooting the basketball, but has shown off more of his patience and playmaking ability as he moves through his career.
Looking at who's out there now for the Bucks. Lopez comes in for P.J. Tucker, and it's Dante DiVincenzo in for Pat Connaughton. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Alder.
Thanks, Kevin. Mike Budenholzer had some words for his team during the break.
His key message was, don't get comfortable. Those guys are going to come at us with everything they've got. Let's bring the intensity and stay focused on every possession. Kevin, back to you.
Thank you, David. Six to shoot, and it's sent back by Lopez. But they get it down, and out of bounds as the Bucks gain possession. His shot was hindered by that momentous mobile one block.
And read the play perfectly. Gets himself in the air at the right moment. Terrific denial.
About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. Now DiVincenzo. Floats one. And the rejection by Eaton. Just five on the clock.
Yeah, my expectations were that he was not going to miss that. And he handles that kind of defense, especially on the inside.
Booker with no one around. Hits it from three-point range. Booker's got 23 points.
And you would think a coach might have talked to his defense about making the adjustment on him, but right now, it's just lighting him up.
Holiday against Paul. Yes, that goes in.
And they worked the ball around so well tonight for those quality looks from mid-range.
And the Suns call time here.
And they're allowing too many points in the paint. Coach is going to let them hear about it.
Yeah, coach knows that. They know that. In the timeout, they're going to hear about it, make the adjustment.
Antetokounmpo's checked in for Bobby Portis. Suns trail by six. Pass to Bridges. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Out to the right wing. All against Holiday. Four on the clock. Lopez with the block. Here's DiVincenzo. Rejected by Booker. And that's out of bounds. Milwaukee will retain possession. The Suns making a switch here. Crowder's checked in. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here, we're just over 2.5 minutes into it. DiVincenzo against Crowder. DiVincenzo gets to Middleton, and it's good, 2 points. Middleton's got 13 points in the second half.
He was sitting back a little bit there in the first half, but feels like showtime now, and he's ready to put some major points up on the board.
So he'll shoot two here.
Yeah, Chris Paul, when he gets into those tight spots, he becomes pretty smart in there.
And the first one drops. And he makes both free throws. And the Bucks with possession here. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Down low, here's DiVincenzo. He's it up and in off the pretty assist. DiVincenzo's got 4 this quarter.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution. And, and they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's +5 in that category.
Outside Holiday. There's the pass to DiVincenzo. Back to Holiday. The Bucks working the ball around. Pass to Middleton. Down to 5 on the shot clock. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. Crowder, the pass to Booker. And the rejection by Antetokounmpo. Suns running out of time. Inside, out of his reaches to Booker. And too much time in the lane, they get called for the 3-second violation. Bucks leading by 9. We've got 1:28 left in the fourth quarter. Here's Middleton, and he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
Middleton out there thinking about the game, and that helps out. Skilled at getting to the free throw line.
So the first one drops, and that'll push the lead to double digits. Middleton hits him both. Phoenix calls timeout. They're trailing by 11. We've got 1:23 left in the fourth quarter. The New Balance player of the game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And in terms of his shooting, this has been one of the more accurate performances you'll ever see. I mean, he's been in constant motion, creating a lot of good looks for himself. But still, even when you're wide open, you expect to miss some of the time. Man, that has not been the case here tonight. This guy has made everything.
Now to come in here facing a hostile crowd and have a game like he's had, that's what separates the good players from the great players. We've got 1:23 left in the fourth. Here's Booker. From down in the low post, it goes. Booker's got 25 points in the game.
Yeah, Booker filling it up quickly here tonight. You got to respect the versatility, especially how dangerous he is on the offensive end.
Here's Holiday. Ball with the defensive effort. And so it's Crowder with it. They'll bring it up for the Suns. They trail by 9 points. A nice shot by Booker.
And Booker, not just an onlooker. How about that one?
Antetokounmpo against Crowder. Antetokounmpo passes to Middleton, and he gets it to go. And the Bucks lead by 8. And that put a hush over the crowd.
Wow, I mean, took these fans out of the game in the blink of an eye.
Inside, defended by Middleton, picks it out the ball, from deep. Antetokounmpo grabs the miss.
And if they know what's good for them, that's the way they'll defend against him every time he takes the ball on the three-point line. And once they smell blood in the water, you could see the killer instinct take over.
Yeah, up until that point, a competitive game, but once they broke through that barrier, it was all them, complete control.
Crowder finds Bridges. From outside, off the mark. Holiday with it. In the corner, Middleton with it. So no problem for Milwaukee as they get the win. They came in here and took care of business like they were the home team.
And Kevin, how about the mental toughness that this group showed? They were never rattled at all by the opposing fans.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Giannis, an impressive performance for you. What was the key?
I just want to thank my teammates because they're doing a great job guiding me. And I'm just trying to, you know, try to be as close as I can wait for my time to finish it.
That looked great tonight, man. I appreciate it. Congratulations. Kevin, back to you.
David, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. And we'll see you next time.